Good evening, one, and welcome to Paradise Botany here in Auckland, New Zealand. I'm your host, Bryce Rouse, alongside Bartosz Iwertowski.
That's right.
And we're going to get ready for game one of the weekend between your Botany Swarm and the travelling team, the West Auckland Admirals. So the Admirals coming off getting 5 out of the available 6 points last weekend in Christchurch. They played 2 hell of a games. Definitely going to come out firing against the Swarm side.
Yeah, I'm excited for this game. Chava, he's back into it. He was looking solid last weekend. Stopped all the shots in the shootout. Made some beautiful saves. That one-timer glove save he made, that was pretty sweet.
It was good. Getting across the crease, too. Yeah. It's probably going to be a goalie matchup today, I would assume. But these two teams are going to absolutely go at it because the Botany Storm want those points so they can try get that first place position so they can have a home final, whereas the Admirals are trying to make sure they do solidify at least third place so they do make the semi-final, maybe even get second, probably not, but possibly.
Yeah, this is going to be a couple of great games this weekend, and definitely will be a goalie battle. There's a lot of goaltending talent on display here. We've got Matt Kennedy against Chuba. Chuba recently returning to the lineup after his big Euro trip, and he's looking sharp, despite the layoff. And on the bench, we've got Grace Harrison for the Botany Swarm, who will probably play tomorrow. A lot of goaltending talent. She could easily be a starter on any other team.
Oh, 100%. She's one of the best goalies in this league, if not the best at the moment. I think her save record actually shows that. But we'll actually go to center ice and do a little celebration for Matt Kennedy, the so-called NZIHL washing machine.
How about that? 82 penalty minutes for a goalie. Is that the first goalie slash enforcer we've seen?
It's pretty impressive, to be honest, isn't it?
I wonder if he'll try and add to that today. He had a suspension earlier this season.
Yeah, I remember that. And also back from suspension will be Fraser Ellis. He got a couple of games. Actually saw his parents down in Christchurch as they organised that at the start of the season, as they go down to one of their, I think it's a holiday home down there or something that they go to every year, so that was pretty cool.
Nice. Do you know what a suspension was for? Do you remember?
I don't actually. It's hard to keep up these days.
Too many suspensions going on. Surprising amount of goalie suspensions this season. We saw Barr get suspended, Matt Kennedy get suspended.
Hey, goalies act up too, you know.
Yeah. We're crazy, as they say.
Absolutely.
There has to be something a little bit wrong with you to want to stand in front of a puck flying at your face over 100 kilometers per hour.
That's for sure. And I actually went away with the Admirals last weekend, and just like last season, I can really see them starting to amp things up a bit, because they went into that finals series last year easily the better team. They were hard done by not to win the Virgil Cup last season, and if they can get a good ramp up going here, they could be a hard team to handle come the end of the season. So we're underway here, game one of the weekend. The host Botany Swarm have their West Auckland rivals here. Probably a 30 to 40 minute commute from the west side of Auckland. Simon's going to put a quick shot on, misses everything though. Hayward Jones will dangle that out. Looks like might have been picked off by a Swarm player at the blue, but Ellis will be able to get that at least into the neutral zone. Kozlov looking for some options, finds Atwell in the middle. He'll just dump it in. He's the only one given chase. Fontaine's coming there now as Regan has to play that behind. Here's Captain Daig. Had a great series last week. He's actually leading his team for most points this season with 6 goals and 8 assists.
Wow, very impressive for a defenseman.
He's definitely the leading goal scorer. Not sure about the points, but definitely for the goals.
Yeah, he has a great release. I've faced him quite a lot in training. I think he definitely has the best shot on the Admirals, so I'm not surprised he scored so many goals.
There's a pass from Sestrone, which Kennedy had to get something on. Kennedy has to make another little stick deflection there. As Moses steals that off Fontaine, couldn't get a centering pass as Ryan McDonald was laying the body down on the floor. Exit pass up to Johnson, unable to control that, but did get a touch, so icing will be waved. And puck stolen here by Johnson on Regan. Tried to go around the back. Chubba was covering the post. Puck is still loose as Regan's going to try to skate it out, but Moses will have to try. Probably need to exit the zone a little bit better, the Admirals here this game, if they're going to deal with this ferocious attack of the Botany Swarm we've seen this season, Bartosz.
Yeah, they're a dangerous team. Stepanek especially. I think we might see some exciting action from him. And Ivan Dolmetal, always dangerous as well.
That he is. And only 18 years old is. Look out, Mawson bats that up into the netting. So we'll get a whistle on the play there.
Yeah, Ivan scored that beautiful goal a few weeks ago against Queenstown. Through the defenseman's legs, through the goalie's legs, undressed everyone. It was a beauty.
That was a very nice goal. Absolutely.
You think that tops his between the legs goal?
Nah, definitely not. No way. That's goal of the season. No one's taking that.
Maybe if he scores in Michigan? Don't think that's been done in the NZIHL yet.
Oh, quick. Chubba had to pounce on that as Hayward Jones was unable to control a centering pass cleanly, so.
Yeah, that almost got messy there.
Yeah.
Good thing Chubba was paying attention.
But like the Swarm have done all season, you make one half mistake and these guys absolutely capitalize on those chances, so you have to be careful down there in the defensive zone. Panic will just turn around from Daigle. Gets his elbow up too as Moses were defending. Dalmatel with a shot, another save there from Chubba, another goal line save from Daig on the line.
Wow, that was close.
The puck had beaten Chubba, but not going to beat Captain Daig from there. A shot there from the point and a good block of save from Chubba. They're having to absorb some early offensive pressure here in the opening 3 minutes of this one.
Complete chaos in front of the net there. I think they hit the post on the rebound before the... Is it Daigle that dived into the net to
Yeah, he was just
that?
He was just sitting in there, wasn't he?
Yeah.
That's
leading
brave.
Scorer and backup goaltender, apparently.
Yeah, he's on the bench here. He looks fine. He's all good. As Fontaine's making a nuisance of himself. Ben Taylor's there to try to steal it, but... Unable to clear was Dylan Dixon, but Ben Stephen will try to take it up ice, but looks like it's picked off there by Fontaine in the neutral zone. He'll get it back. Nice moves here from Fontaine, using his skill and pace to go through a few defenders, but finally coughs it up. And Thula's on it for the Swarm. Trying to find, I think it's Kozak, it is.
Luckily the defenseman tied up his stick.
Yeah, it looks like the third or fourth line now up there now. Four, here's a shot by Kozak from the sharp angle, but Chubba's going to see that one all the way. You've got to get him moving a little bit more left and right there, I think, Bartek.
Yeah, great work there. So he went to the RVH positions. We call it one leg down, one leg up, sealed the post. So great work, great technical save.
That round to McLeish. Those two teamed up really well last weekend. Played some good hockey. So did the Kennedy brothers. As Sestrani will just put that diagonally into the corner. Sestrani trying to find Vespo, who was crashing the net. He had Henry up high. But Kennedy's going to cover that one up.
Yeah, both teams trying those tight angle jam plays. Testing if the goalies are sharp. They're playing positionally. Those sneak in more than you would expect.
But a Nickelback playing in the background as play gets back underway.
Classic Canadian music.
This is trying to try to find Vespa behind the net, but he couldn't control that as Henry will give it up to the point for McLeish. He'll put one on a shot, a redirect there from Vespa, but went wide.
That could have been dangerous.
Absolutely. And icing waved off as Whitson Lee will be the first attacker there for the Swarm. Nelson's going to try chase down Sestrani, but he gets it up to Vespa, who was unable to control it. So Ryan McDonald will look to set up a play. High saucer pass, misses everyone. As the panic steals that from Regan. Oh, Regan doing so well to stay with the play. And just not kept in there by Thula, as these lines in paradise are extremely hard to see, Bartosz.
Yeah, and apologies to the people
in
watching.
In simple words, they need to be repainted.
I think it's even worse watching on TV than it is in person. I think I watched a few replays. You could not see the lines at all.
No, you can't. You can't. You're like, oh, do they have lines or just open ice?
I promise there actually is a blue line. It is very faint, though. The referees are not just making it up. Nice dangle
here's
there.
The panic. Shot on. Chubba didn't get it cleanly. Another rebound try from Dalmatow. Looks like he put it wide. Didn't hit any traffic in front. As Thula puts a shot on. Chubba doesn't know where it is. Puck is loose. He did make the save, but didn't know anything about it, as that was going through about four or five players worth of traffic. McDonald unable to control that nicely at the puck, so they will have to touch up. What the Swarm have done well all season so far is, even when they're not on that offensive rush, they are still maintaining the position of the puck, which ultimately is going to win you a lot of games.
Yeah, they've definitely had the most offensive zone time, and their neutral zone play has looked good so far. Admirals haven't left their zone very much so far.
As Simon tries to spin around from Daigle, receives a hit there from Moses. Good 50-50 collision there. As Hayward Jones bats at him. Look out there, Gavin.
Have you noticed the Swarm are doing that high chip play that the Florida Panthers use very effectively in the NHL playoffs this season? They're lofting in and high and hoping the defenseman can't handle it while their forward pressures them. Almost worked out for Stepanek earlier.
Yeah, which he actually didn't control cleanly first either, which... As just offside, Fontaine unable to get back as the puck did go in just before he touched up. So we see here Tyler Hazelmore, not the head ref here tonight, a linesman, if you will. Trying to get a few other badges to add to the collection, I'd say.
Sorry, who is that? Who is the linesman?
The ref. Tyler Hazelmore.
Oh, yep. Was he a former Swarmer Admirals player?
No, I don't believe he is.
Oh, yeah.
Good battle there in the corner as Ollie Hay, first time seeing him tonight. Stolen there from Kozak, centering pass, scores! It's Fontaine, and the Swarm get a 1-0 lead.
Absolutely no chance for Chuba there. That was a defensive breakdown. Player in front of the net, tucks it in far side. Only thing he could have done is maybe poked his stick out and got his stick on it, but that's an extremely difficult play for the goaltender. And that maybe sloppy defensive play has come back to bite the Admirals.
Yeah, it was Ellis going for the poke check pass, which Kozak read really well. You definitely don't want to be giving the puck over to Kozak when he's at that area of the ice.
But well done by Jackson getting the goal. He's looked sharp so far. Rewarded.
Andy Hay will pass it around to Whitson Lee. McLeish will just bang that in. Silva setting up. Whitson Lee goes up to Mawson. Johnson gets rubbed out on the board there from McLeish. Puck comes out of the zone.
Time
and
goal, 6:48 in the first period. That
Swarm
goal by Fontaine from Kozak.
Regan will play it up the boards. Pulisov almost trying to steal it. Will be kept in there though by Sandoy. As Moses tried to play it over to Stroney, picked off there by Pulisov. He'll rip one from over the blue. Chuba will make no trouble of that. As Dalmatow was trying to get a little bit of a sniff as Chuba put the puck on the ice there for a second.
He's very keen to get on the score sheet.
Oh yeah, he's hungry for points, isn't he?
Luckily he didn't get a face wash after the whistle from the defenseman for poking at the goalie.
Oh, that was all right, I reckon. that was okay. You goalies are a little bit soft, aren't you?
We are touchy.
Up to the point. McDonald looks like hit some traffic in front. Moses will be first there to it. Admirals unable to clear. Pulisov finds Dalmatow. He shoots. Good save there from Chuba. Came off the glove. Kept in. Chuba's got no stick at the moment. It's just to his left as defenseman Rooney finally knocks it over for him.
Man,
as Rooney will come the other way.
Chuba.
Puts a quick shot on, but that misses everything entirely. Won't be able to keep that inside the zone as Mason Kennedy will see his first shift of the night. Here's the panic. Quick turn of events, shot on, and that just missed over the crossbar. If that was a little bit lower, that looked destined to be in the back of the net as Moses was pushing on there from Kozak.
Yeah, it could easily be 3-0 right now if Chuba hadn't made that huge save and Stepanek hadn't ripped it over the net.
And here's the speedster, Jacko Fontaine. He can really get going. He's got the hands too to go with it. Puts a shot on. Net comes off its mooring, so Chuba had it covered up anyway.
Yeah, Jackson's looking sharp. He's keen for more goals. But what a save by Chuba. That was a clutch save. He didn't make the beautiful windmill glove save. Didn't manage to keep it in the pocket, but that was spectacular. You notice him playing without his stick. It used to be the common wisdom that defensemen should give a stick to the goaltender if the goaltender loses it. But it's not considered a good idea anymore. You don't need to make stick saves like you used to back in the day. Face-off wasn't taken correctly, I guess. Going to redo it.
Just thinking, we haven't seen too much of that first line for the Admirals here tonight for some reason.
Interesting. Wonder if maybe someone's got a niggling injury.
So I was wondering where. Looks like they are destined to head out next, so they definitely need to get Riley Smith going as he's definitely one of their best offensive players.
Right. I heard that he's naturally a defenseman, and he's been put in that forward position, actually, but still doing well.
Here's Luke Simon. Receives a good hit there from Daig as well for his troubles. As Dixon will play it up this near side to Ellis. Good stick in the lane there from Thula. Ellis stealing it back though, trying to find a centering pass as Smith. The man I was just talking about was looking to go into the slot to jump on a pass.
Yeah, you're right, that line's looking good.
Absolutely. Here's Ollie Hay. He had a great weekend last weekend. Quick shot on, pad save there. Rebound try from Smith. And another good save there from Canada.
Wow, what a save.
And that will be icing, so the Swarm will not be allowed to change on that. But I think the Admirals will keep that first line out there, and why not, as they got a couple of good opportunities there.
Just seeing the replay now. Wow. Was that off his pad, off his blocker? It was hard to see from that angle, but incredible save there from Matt Canaday. Keep him up 1-0.
And Sam Pillage clears that only as far as Finn Hayward-Jones almost picked off the pass there. Mawson, as he was looking for Daigle. Not cleared initially by Thula. Ellis doing well, he steals it back. Leaves it low for Smith. Try to find Ellis in the middle, unable to control that. It was off the skate, so he's gonna look for a change as Sandoy will play it up to the wing. Johnson in the zone, good stick though there by Daigle, actually breaks it. Regan up to Smith. And dumped in as Smith and Daigle will get a change. Regan just bats that in deep for Ollie Hay to run onto. Ollie Hay actually getting his first goal for the Admirals last weekend as well. Definitely looking to add a couple more to that tally here tonight. Does well, very well, Ollie Hay to keep that in. Maybe one too many moves, probably need to get a shot off, but nonetheless.
Oh, referee takes a tumble.
Yep, definitely got a look out with Polozov's crashing at you. And here goes Vespa. It's a strong with a shot and looks like it hit the skate of McDonald and hit the upper netting as well.
He's got a great shot when he gets it on that. I've seen him smash the glass a few times in training.
It's a strong?
Yep.
Vinny? Yeah.
Yeah, just a wrister into the glass and then he was cleaning up the glass for another 20 minutes after that.
I remember the Swarm had a guy, Tamil Rantanen, he was from Finland. He actually, you see the other pane of plastic, which used to be glass behind the goal down there? Yep, that was him, and it was a shot from the blue line as well.
Ooh.
Just in training.
Yeah, so far I've seen Vinny and Gareth smash the glass at Avondale in training.
Quick shot there from Rooney, good block by Ryan McDonald, had to be made. Could have been dangerous, says here's a good 2-on-1. Fontaine Kozak, he just couldn't get a clean shot off, and he goes crashing into the net as well.
Oh, good to see he's okay. That could have been nasty.
Yeah, I'm not sure. I don't think it was any dirty play there from Caleb Chamberlain, but he was the last man back, but we'll have a look.
It was just a hockey play, but it's always a bit scary when someone slides into the post.
Oh, that leg looked like it went, might have to look at it again. I think the shoulders and everything are fine, but looks like the skate might have done something.
Maybe a little bit of a trip from Caleb?
Maybe.
Well, he's got away with it.
Yeah, well, that can be reviewed. That's not my job. We'll leave that to the experts.
To the situation room down in Wellington.
Atwell on Mason Kennedy. I think it's the first time I've seen Atwell out there tonight, and what a way to make an entrance. That guy sometimes just gets out on the ice and absolute headhunts.
Yeah, is he on the top line with Stepanek and Kozak, is that right? Or have they split them up?
I think they split them up a little bit.
Sprinkled all the offense throughout their lineup instead.
Bring Atwell on as that kind of bruiser guy when you need him.
Yeah, he's a big guy. Got a great shot too.
Oh yeah, he can definitely play. As Mawson finds a good pass up to Whitson Lee, but he's pressured there from Zach Stephen. Whitson Lee, though, staying with the play. and going to dangle their way out of the zone of the Admirals through Sebastian Stephen and Ben Taylor. But Sandoy, he's been around the league quite a while. He knows that speed isn't the best thing out there on the ice. It's definitely skill.
I'm sure he has lots of skill considering they call him Niue and Gretzky.
Well, you'd have to, right?
Greatest player ever to come out of Niue.
Good turnover there from Sebastian Stephen. Trying to find Dylan Dixon, but Thula's going to break up the play. Good, well kept in there from Flynn Hayward-Jones. And Johnson getting a stick inside that shooting lane, so no trouble there for Canada. As Polozov will, nice source pass over to Stepanek. Haven't seen too much of Stepanek tonight. Looks like they're rolling lines. Here's Polozov! Should have shot, and the net has come off. Sasha Polozov, you need to shoot there, buddy.
Yeah, a little bit too patient.
too patient, that's way too patient.
Just like everything, good in moderation.
Look at that. Oh, it's a little bit
The cameraman wasn't even.
Yeah, he had it controlled so nicely, though. He should have shot.
Oh, yeah. I think, yeah, if he one-timed that, even if he didn't get a clean shot on it, I think Chaba would have really struggled to get across there.
Here's Polozov again, though. Good thing for him, he's such a good player. He always makes sure he manufactures a few more chances during the later stages of the game, so.
Yeah, you'll probably get another one.
So panic. And a shoot. Little pass. Polozov will just bat that at Chaba from the side. Looks like the net's come off again.
Yeah,
it's an issue around the whole of the country at the moment. These nets are just coming off far too easily.
Yeah, for the viewers who watch the NHL, you might notice that they use drilled pegs. So they use a drill and drill all the way down to the concrete and use these long rubber pegs. They don't pop off quite as easily. It's annoying for the goaltenders as well, because if you want to push off the post, the net goes flying everywhere if you don't have proper pegs. Get the league commissioner to look into it, maybe. Invest in some better pegs.
Probably a good time to do that when they repaint the lines.
Better pegs, better lines. That's what we need.
Better hockey as well.
Hockey's quite good so far, but could always do with Kiwi McDavid playing in these rinks. Soon to be discovered, I'm sure.
Yeah, I think his name's Ivan. But nonetheless, play will resume. McDonald keeps in, gets a shot on. Atwell looking for a redirect, but missed everything. Admirals should be able to clear this through Ellis. Dodged a hit there too from Atwell. Shot there from Smith. Hit the glass behind, so Kende will be able to cover that up nice and easily.
Kende is keen to get his hands on the puck. He hasn't had too much action so far. Can be difficult as a goalie when you're a bit cold. He's going to need to put his feet in a hot bath during the intermission to stay warm.
He's only have to face four shots here so far as opposed to the Swarm's 12.
Yeah, Chuba's done well to keep it 1-0.
Here's Mawson. He'll just dump that one in. Looks like it's Max Hill giving chase there. Banged around by McLeish. Puck finally out as Vesper had to come tidy up. Simon will put on the brakes. There's pressure there from Vesper, though. He's stolen it back, trying to go on the near side. As Strone plays that up to McLeish, he'll just kind of shoot that one in. Well kept in there by Henry. As Regan will just backhand that one into space. Skate onto it. Dodges a hit there too from Simon. Played up to the point
pressure
once again.
They haven't had much zone pressure until now.
Yep, that's what they need to keep doing. Keep the Swarm in their zone and get some scoring opportunities. Got to get some shots on net. As Regan leaves that behind for Vespa, he'll get around to Sastronia. Centering feed there, but no one home. So Mawson will try to go through McLeish, but he plays the body well. Polozov's going to have it behind the Admiral's net. Puts a quick shot on. Chubba will make a good save on that, though.
Good positional save. It's sometimes tempting to leave your post a bit early and you leave that short side exposed, but Chubba stayed patient, didn't panic, made a good save with his chest. Unfortunately, they didn't get any shots from that bit of zone pressure, but it was good to see the Admirals applying some pressure to the Swarm.
They definitely got to get a bit more of that going, for sure. Here's Andy Hay. He'll quickly rip one, and Chubba comes across and snatches that with the glove.
Yeah, the baseball-style catch.
That was, definitely.
Yeah, Swarm
little,
have been...
Little change up there on the outside.
Yeah, they've been doing well to get point shots through the Chubba with traffic. The defenseman moved the screen out of the way for Chubba, luckily, but there's a few where he didn't get to see it, and it just hit him.
Hayward Jones will wrap that around, but Thula is going to be there for the Swarm. Looks like Ollie Hayd did well to bat that out of mid-air as Daigle's going to come the other way for the Admirals. Riley Smith just stays onside. Good shot there from Daigle. Stick save was made from Kennedy. And a goalie-to-goalie pass here as Chubba had to come and play that as Pozov tried to find a pass up to Stepanek, but it looks like a good stick lift. Moving at pace here. And Smith will shoot one, scores!
Oh!
Riley Smith with a very lovely shot past the blocker of Matt Kennedy.
That came out of nowhere there. I wonder, I think maybe he
Look
was screened a little bit.
That was good.
Yeah, I'm guessing Matt Kennedy was screened just as the release, yeah, just as the puck came off his stick. It looked like he reacted a bit late to that one. That was from quite a tight angle.
Yeah, because it was over obviously here on the near side, and then I think the Swarm defenseman was right in the lane, and he probably thought he wouldn't be shooting from that angle, but...
Yeah, or maybe those defensemen will get the block.
Chance here to make it two as Ollie Hay hits the back post, receives a good hit there from McDonald as well. As Fontaine will bat that out of the zone. Only as far as Dake, who finds Ollie Hay. Ollie Hay with a shot, good glove save there from Kennedy as he makes the splits as well there, Bartosz.
Very flashy, showing off that stylish 90s style glove save. He's trying to add to his highlight reel.
And he's got quite the good one. So it'll be Ben Taylor up against Atwell. Atwell definitely won that one cleanly. Is that well over to Fontaine. Fontaine trying to go through. I think that's Zach Steven, but a good skate in the lane. Otherwise, that would have been trouble. Nice pass up to Zach Steven. Unable to corral it cleanly, though. Kept in by Sandoy. Kozak tries to find Simon. He does. Temporarily gets around Dixon. A quick shot in the high point area. Hit a defenseman in front.
Yeah, he's going to need an ice pack during the intermission for that.
Absolutely. Johnson comes and cleans that up. Tries to go through the legs of Nash Hayward-Jones. Fontaine showing all the moves here at the moment.
Incredible skating there. Wow.
Couple of shimmy la-las.
Lots of shimmy lolos there.
As Nash Hayward-Jones plays it up to Dixon. He'll just dump that in. Two players will get a change as it looks like the second line's coming out there for the Admirals. We've got Sistrone and Henry. Those guys are best roommates for sure.
It's the inline line, as they call them, right?
That's true. Here comes Regan the other way. He'll be able to go coast to coast. Looking for a shot. He looked it for the pass. And looks like Ryan McDonald was coming back nicely. Good shot there from Moses. Kennedy is going to have to cover that up.
I think a little bit too unselfish.
Absolutely. Definitely got to get a shot off there.
He
no,
actually has
no
quite
question
a good shot
it.
Regan. He scored on me quite a few times in training. And in warm-up since he plays for my team, the Mooseheads in the BHL.
Oh, yep. scored a bit on my goalie too, but wouldn't talk about that. As Simon will not get that out as Chamberlain's lurking.
1 minute running in the first period.
And Sando will get that out. Good work here from, I think that's is that Ben Stephen or Zach Stephen?
I think that was Ben. Naughty yeah. boy with a cross check to the head.
Oh,
away with it.
He's a battler, that guy. He's a feisty kid. I actually had a fight with him in the BHL
this
season. Yep. There's the panic. He's going to look for a shot. Hit the back of Polozov. So one all here at the moment in the opening games. And that puck does just go outside the zone, so it will be offside on the play.
It crossed that invisible line. I promise there's a blue line.
Where? Oh, well, I thought we'd just make it up.
There is some integrity in this sport. This is serious business, New Zealand ice hockey. Do you know what team Ben Stephen plays for in the BHL?
I think it's Mooseheads. I can't remember.
No, that's Zach Stephen. I don't know if Ben played BHL. Were you fighting him in the stands?
No, I was on the ice. And that's going to do it. No, it's not. We'll get a whistle. 1.3 to go. What do you make of this first period so far, Bartosz?
I think the Admirals are very lucky to be tied at the end of this period.
That's fair. Yeah.
They're going to be thanking their goalie after this period, I think. And their defenseman for a few shot blocks. One second left now. See what we can do.
And yeah, it looked like Riley Smith tried to go for the shot as well. Right off the faceoff, but just missed. So
you could see the defenseman teeing up for a slapper if he wanted, but he decided to go for it himself.
Yeah, the Emerald boys are actually going to go give a high five to Chuba because he's been amazing so far in this game.
Yeah, well deserved. He's made some huge saves. And I think maybe the Swarm could have had a bit more killer instinct on a few of those plays. Like Polozov didn't go for the shot.
Got to shoot.
Too much patience.
But also Regan gone down the left there. Yeah. Didn't shoot either. So
both teams a little bit too unselfish, a little bit too patient. Sometimes you just got to get your head down and hit the puck at the net.
That's right. You got to get these shots on net because the less shots you get, the less goals you are going to get, right?
Yeah. Sometimes they call the sport luck puck.
Luck puck? Yeah. You got to get puck on net though, so.
Yeah. You need some of those lucky bounces. You got to be good to be lucky, and you got to be lucky to be good, as they say.
That's true. So only one goal apiece here so far. The Swarm probably being the better team, but we did see some good firepower when the Admirals do get going, getting good pressure deep in the zone. So anything can happen for the rest of the game, believe that. So we'll take a quick break, ladies and gentlemen, and be back here very shortly for period two.
looks like we've got some future Admirals and Swarm players out there.
Yeah, and who other than the referee slash coach slash everything, AJ Spiller?
The man, the myth, the legend. Ooh, what a dangle.
Yeah, oh, still got it.
See, that was almost like the Swarm's first goal, but the goalie managed to save it. Oh, what a save. Outrageous save by the goalie there. Whoa. Another one, a toe save. A future Grace Harrison right there, maybe. Team Red struggling to get out of their zone. Oh, no.
Oh. And
she's being beat.
And he looks at Chubba and Grace as he's skating off, going, yeah, just nodding his head.
Oh, no. Another goal for Team Green. Team Red's going to need to put on the pressure to come back with 28 seconds left, I believe, until they get kicked off. Big save. Green goalie's looking very keen to finally get a shot. Two nil for Team Green. Oh, and a naughty play, putting the puck in after the whistle. Suspension worthy, maybe?
Could be.
So at the moment, shots are 13-7 for the Swarm, so the Admirals managed to get a few at the end of that period. And I think they'll want to come out strong and build on the end of that period.
Yeah, they definitely clawed back, and they had to, because they were getting outplayed there for sections of that first period. So good to see them, you know, starting to fight back a bit, find their feet. They did start the game quite slowly in their first game in Christchurch. Looks like they've probably done it here tonight, but it looks like they're going to come right. So, and it is going to be the period of the long shift as well, so you've got to be that little bit more careful when changing for a teammate.
Chubba showing off his flexibility there, doing the splits too, showing that he can do it just as good as Kende. I'm quite jealous. I wish I could do the splits.
I think I have seen you. You're downplaying yourself there, aren't you?
Not quite as good as these guys out here, but I do my best.
So the goalies are ready. Zebra, the man in the stripes, gets period two underway. Flynn Haywood-Jones is going to put that one in deep. He's actually gone over to the Netherlands to further his career at the end of this season.
Oh, really? Is he going to university or just for
OE? I think he's meeting up with Chubba Senior, I believe.
Oh, I see.
Here's the panic. I haven't seen too much of him so far today. This one will definitely want to get him a little bit more involved.
That'll be a big loss for the Admirals, having Flynn go away.
It's got to be done, though. We've got to keep developing these types of players that are young.
He's only 21 years old, I think. Is that right?
Yeah, around there, yeah.
Man, he's such a good defenseman. For his age, especially.
As Polozov finds a centering feed, comes off the skate of someone, he's actually going to get it back, gives it up to the point. Thula with a good shot, good block in the lane there from Ellis. And a redirect there! Fontaine scores!
Wow, two for Fontaine. He is on fire today.
And that's an awesome redirect here. So the shot initially blocked there by Ellis. Good job of that. And then McDonald making sure he keeps it low, and then Fontaine just giving the stick out there.
That is a goal scorer's goal.
Yeah,
that is in the right place at the right time. Gets a stick on it. No chance for Chaba, really. That's both goals. He hadn't really had a chance on them.
Here goes Henry trying to get something going here for the Admirals. Still with it, but finally lose it as Fontaine's unable to clear. Kept in well by Henry. As Thaler turns away from Sestrone. Little saucer pass over to his D partner. As calm as he like, as here's Fontaine looking for a hat-trick. Passes over to Kozak, but that was just ahead of him. That could have been the Swarm's third. And very unselfish play from Fontaine there. Like, the guy's on a hat-trick, but definitely electing to play the best players, which Regan gets absolutely crunched there by McDonald. Moses with a shot just misses the left post. Looks like Thula wasn't able to clear as Moses was coming in for a second attempt, so Kennedy's going to have to get a whistle there.
That was good they got a shot on net after that slow start to the period. But yeah, Jackson's absolutely flying out there. He's dangling, he's scoring, setting up his teammates.
And he is an absolutely hilarious guy too. If you only got to spend 5-10 minutes with him to know he's a proper joker.
I'm actually teaching him at the University of Auckland this semester. He's in my Math 250 class.
Oh, really?
Apparently a very bright student. I'm teaching the second half of the class, so haven't had him for my lectures yet, but see if he cracks some jokes in class.
There's Mason Kennedy. Haven't seen any sign of TK here today. Not sure what he is up to. Definitely a guy they would find a lot of value in this type of game.
Yeah, I thought I saw him on the roster sheet. Wonder if maybe he got hurt in warm-ups or earlier today at the morning skate.
Do they actually have a morning skate?
I don't know. I hope so.
I don't think there's enough time, to be honest, in the rink schedules. Nonetheless, a morning skate would be lovely, wouldn't it? So Dalmatow's going to go to work here. Here's the panic, trying to find a shot. Good stick on Dalmatow to tie him up. Good work there from Mason Kennedy. Up to the point. Thula with a one-time hit Rooney. Couple of loose pucks going everywhere as the panic's going to have it on his stick. Try to find Dalmatow, he does. Misses, oh, pulls off, scores!
Well, no chance for Chaba there again. He's being hung out to dry.
Absolutely, as Polozov finally got that last touch. So Stepanek found Dalmatow up high in the slot area. He missed that shot just as we saw, and then Polozov just taps it home, and he just gets through as well.
He didn't try to be patient that time. He just whacked it.
You gotta.
That's what you should have done the first time. Just get the puck on net. Doesn't matter if you get good contact if the goalie's not on the net.
That's so true.
This game might be getting away from the Admirals. They're gonna have to tighten up, play some better defense to help out Chaba, and hopefully try and get something past Canada.
So Ollie Hay up against Atwell. Atwell is actually rocking some new skates there, those Hyperlites. They're looking fresh. Going up against Ollie Hay's marks, the all blacked out Supreme line. And here
maybe
comes
you
Atwell.
Should be selling skates at center ice.
Shot there from Atwell, maybe. And the net comes off. It's pulled back on by Chubba though, so we won't get a whistle.
That might have been a mistake. He should have left it off. Could have gotten a whistle there.
Smith's going to give it to Dago. He shoots, and a good blocker save there from Kennedy.
I think maybe like, collarbone. Yeah. I don't know if that was the blocker. That's
just
the soft,
that's just old
soft
age.
Bits.
Yeah, Matt will just say that's just old age. Don't worry about it. Yeah, look like... Look by the collarbone, but... he's a tough character.
Definitely is. I think he broke his finger earlier this season. Came back after 2 weeks, I think.
Memoirs of a goalie. So Whitson Lee going to stuck there in the corner against Zach Stephen. Zander will turn away from Taylor.
Zach must be the one that you fought in the BHL.
No, it was definitely Ben. He's the blonder one of the two.
Yeah, you got dark hair Zach, blonde Ben, and ginger Sebastian.
Right, Steven. Simon rips a shot, missing everything. Put in deep by Sandoy as Whitson Lee tries to turn away from Taylor but just loses the puck. Admirals will finally clear that and looks like Zach Steven received a good hit there from Mawson. So that's Sebastian Steven. Here's Zach Steven now. Here's Dalmatau. He shoots one but misses the pad side of Chubba. Stepanek's going to come tidy up. Gives up to the point from Tula. Good block in the lane there from Taylor. Polozov trying to find Stepanek. Unable to control it nicely though as he had Dixon hot on his tail. Stepanek gets it back. Here's Dalmatau. Backhand shot. Chubba makes a good couple of saves there and keeps that from being four.
Wow, the Swarm are looking hot. They're buzzing around the net. Good thing Chubba had his paddle down to seal the ice there. Didn't let anything through. One more goal and this game gets away from the Admirals.
That's right. The next goal is absolutely crucial in this game. Because the way the Swarm are playing this season, I would not want to be down three goals to them.
Definitely not.
And here comes Stepanek, red hot this season. Tried to pass it over to Polozov, but a good tracking back job there by Henry.
Yeah, I think he saved a goal there, possibly.
Definitely. Henry once again on the forecheck, chasing Sandoy. Dalmatau will clear that out. Here's Polozov, they've got a 3-on-2 here, the Swarm. Here's Thula, gives it back to Polozov, backhand, just misses. Good chance there for Sasha.
Wow, the Swarm are looking so sharp out there. Admirals need to stop this momentum.
Lula bangs it up to Fontaine, hits his skate, so there will be no icing as Kozak's trying to get away from McLeish as Chamberlain comes and helps out. A scrum forms on the far side. Ryan McDonald gives up to center ice to Fontaine, but only goes as far as Regan. He'll rip one and straight into the breadbasket of Canada. He will never miss those.
Yeah, he realized there was no other passing threat, so he grabbed some white ice at the top of his crease, made himself big, and there's not much room for Regan to shoot at then.
So they hay up against Atwell. So we've got Ollie Hay on the Admirals, and his brother Andy Hay is on the Swarm. Here's Captain Daig. His shot was initially blocked. Swarm are going to clear. As Kozak will put the brakes, tries to get away from Daigle, finds Fontaine in the high slot, but pressured on there really well by Smith. Here's a chance. Kozak with it again, shoots and hits the side of the net.
I think it might have been Chubba's stick actually. Did well to get back across there.
Daigle will play to Smith.
Admirals just can't leave the zone. Finally do.
But not for too long as the Swarm are going to come back the other way. Fontaine puts on the brakes. Oh, almost found Johnson. Well picked off there from Captain Dake. So Smith will come away with it. Well, the Admiral's trying to go through everyone as he receives a hit there from Ryan McDonald. Fontaine looks like he's been out there for an hour now. And I don't know how that's called offside when...
I don't think the referees could see the lines either.
He went inside the zone and then came straight out with the puck, but there was no other offensive player in the zone, so...
Referees got a bit confused about where the lines are, I think.
And I don't blame them, because those lines are terrible, Bartosz.
So, to the rink manager, if you're watching, please repaint those lines.
Definitely. So the refs will want to reset that face-off as they weren't happy with something.
Yeah, and if you're watching as well, rink manager, please get some fancy pegs. We would really appreciate it.
Yeah.
Yeah, so the nets don't keep coming off every 5 minutes, every time a goalie bumps it.
Hey, that actually works out well. Do something for the refs and the goalies to make the rest of the players happy.
That's right.
There you go.
Everyone's going to be happy.
There you go. As Sestrone tries to clear that, but only found Mawson, who does well to keep it in. Johnson pressured on there by Ben Stephen. It's Ben Stephen, nice little move off the wall. Sestrone trying to find a breakout pass, but Whitson Lee will have it, and that shot is going to hit the upper netting. So
that was a good goalie play there by Chaba. So. For the goalies watching at home, the young goalies, so you want to get your stick on those low shots and create just the right angle with your stick blade. So you angle the puck up into the glass or the netting, as you saw there. No rebound, and you get a stoppage in play that way. So well done by Chaba. That's a veteran goalie move there.
Delmatow and Moses got a work shot there from Sandoy. It was nice and low, but was missing everything. As Pozov turns away there from Chamberlain. Pozov so nifty. With it again, gives up to the point. Simon will shoot, another redirect, scores! It's Delmatow! He's claiming it. We'll have to see the replay, but it definitely hit someone in front, and that's going to be 4-1 to the Botany Swarm.
Yeah, that's another one. You can't blame Chaba for that. Look at all that traffic. I don't think he saw it until the last second. Yeah, great deflection by Delmatow. Two good deflections by Jackson, and then Delmatow. No chance for Chaba, really. Poor guys being hung out to dry there. And... yeah, this game is getting away from the Admirals. They need something quick to break this momentum.
That they do. It's already 4-1, almost halfway through this game.
The shots are only 19-12, but that doesn't tell the full story of the quality of the chances that the Swarm have generated. A lot of them have been from high danger areas or shots through screens, deflections. Could easily be 6-1.
So Sebastian Stephen will just dump that one in. Received a hit for his troubles as well. Sandoy there to pick things up. And just give it around to Outwell. Fontaine, who just turns away from Dixon.
Look at him fly.
Almost got past another defenseman there. That would have been a really good run.
Easily player of the game so far, Jackson.
And here's Smith. He can definitely get something going on. Gives it to Ollie Hay. He'll rip one, but looks like it hit Nguyen Gretzky. He looks a bit sore from it too.
Ouch. Like as we said last time, he should probably be called Nguyen Bobby Orr, since he's a defenseman.
Ellis doing really well. Ollie Hay comes and tidies up. Ellis with a shot straight into Kennedy, though. Won't trouble him from that angle.
Yeah, the Admirals need to get traffic in front if they want to give him problems with those sort of shots. If the goalie can see it from tight angle at the point, it's going to be a save 99.99% of the time. Making it too easy for Kennedy. Which I'm sure he's disappointed about because he can't make any fancy windmill glove saves.
Ollie Hay wins that nicely. Daig with it. He'll shoot, but it hit the shin pad of Dalmatow. Smith. Shot on. Traffic in front. Puck still loose. Goes into the corner. Polozov's going to come away with it. Oh, look out, Gavin again.
Ouch.
Yeah. Gavin, where's the tomatoes down there, buddy? Look out for them.
That was a bit better there. You saw they got some traffic in front of Kennedy, and he struggled to find that for a second until the swarm cleared out of his crease. That's what they need to do. Keep it simple. Get bodies in front of Kennedy. Get the puck to the net. Obscure his vision.
They definitely need to get a couple goals back here in this period. Because you know the Swarm are not going to turn things down at all. They've been a full game kind of team from start to finish.
Another puck into the net.
Yep, that's Mawson tried to make a glove save, but didn't come off too well.
Yeah, the player gloves aren't very well equipped for that. I've played as a player a few times, and my goalie instincts kicked in. I tried to catch a puck with my player glove. Did not go so well. Would not recommend it.
Actually hurts quite a bit, to be honest, if it's moving.
Yep.
Nice pass there from Stepanek over to Polozov. He's pressured on. As Andy Hay will give it over to Luke Simon. Up the boards to Polozov. Nice pass there to Dalmatow. Finds Stepanek. This line can just find each other on a dime. Centering pass up to Polozov, but Sebastian Steven doing well.
Great breakout play from the Swarm. You see they break out very cleanly from their zone.
Here's Kozak. Goes the forehand, just loses control. Atwell tried it. Stepanek trying to find a centering pass. No one there. I just realized we haven't had a penalty so far in this game, Bartosz.
Yeah, there's been a few plays that could have been penalized, but the refs are swallowing their whistles. Except on offside calls.
Regan gets crunched there from McDonald. No Marcus McDonald out there for the Swarm today.
Oh yeah, young 16-year-old Marcus. It's been solid this season.
Nice thing waved off there is Zach Steven pressured on from Fontaine.
Admirals are just trying to stop the bleeding here.
Sebastian Stevens going to gain the zone here for the Admirals. Put one on net, but easy pickings there for Kennedy.
Yeah, he can't windmill that one. He's probably disappointed.
Yeah, definitely got to be shooting a little bit harder and faster than that if you're going to try beat an in-form Kennedy.
Yep. At least get something in front of his eyes. But at least they've got an offensive zone face-off here. Maybe they can create something.
Johnson will clear it for the Swarm. Couldn't have Jones positioned really nicely there. Didn't give Whitson Lee a good jump, so Chubba can easily cover that up.
Now the Swarm get an offensive zone face-off. There's been a lot of botched face-offs this game. Been calling it back quite a lot.
It's good to see a packed out hive though here tonight. Even around behind the goals, fans standing all around the glass.
Yeah, it's great to see. I think everyone's real keen to see how this turns out. The Admirals battling to keep their playoff spot and the Swarm battling for first place.
As Ellis, nice hit there on Thula. Try to find a centering pass to Ollie Hay. He does get a shot off, but Kende once again making a good save. Admirals clawing themselves back a little bit here, trying to get a little bit of momentum back. It's slowly working. They just got to keep that pressure on the Swarm defenseman, keep it in the zone, and they're going to get scoring opportunities. So,
yeah, I think their only scoring opportunity this period has been when they got Matt Kende's eyes and created a scramble in front of the net. The rest of the shots that Kende has faced have been quite easy.
As Ellis tried to turn a wrist shot there, as Daigle puts one on net. And Kende loves to rack up the saves, doesn't he?
Yeah, he slid out of his net there to make that one. I think that was headed for the boards. But might as well stop the play, get a whistle.
I would have made that one, mate.
I'm sure you would have made that one.
Pozov pressured on, but Stepanek's going to have it for the Swarm. Leaves it on for Andy Hay even. He put a shot on. Looks like it hit someone in front. Puck does come out to center ice. And as the Swarm will put the puck in deep. Smith is going to be there first for the Admirals, but unable to control it nicely as Atwell will come steal that off him. Here's Sandoy up top. They'll just put it in low as Polozov was looking for a change. Kozak's out there. Ollie Hay a little bit too cash. He picked off there from Stepanek. Shot on there, but Chubba had to make a good save. So,
yeah, good job, Chubba. He stayed on his post, didn't panic, and made a good positional save.
We might see the replay. The Admiral's defenseman just a little bit too casual, especially when you got 6'6" Peter Stepanek out there, who has got a work rate of a horse.
Yeah, and he's a big boy. He's hard to knock off the puck. He can really drive it to the net, create some chaos in front.
And there we go, first penalty of the evening. It's going to go to the Admirals in the form of Ollie Hay.
Did you see what happened there?
I did not, actually. I would say it's probably hooking for some reason. It looked like he might have, I don't know.
Yeah, it could be. Maybe a hold. Maybe we'll hear the announcement soon.
There we go, Swarm on the power play. Here's Ryan McDonald's shot. Hits McLeish in front. So Fontaine will look to get something going. He fakes a shot, then finally does.
And the net's off again.
I can see the net's off its moorings, yep. Oh.
Please, rink manager.
It's just killing the game, isn't it?
Get some proper posts for us. I mean, it's good for the Admirals. Get a whistle there.
Like, I definitely see it happen in Avondale. I definitely see it happen in Christchurch. I don't think I saw it in Dunedin. And I would imagine it probably doesn't happen in Queenstown.
Yeah. I'm not sure. I kind of doubt any of the rinks here use the proper marsh pegs, the drilled pegs. But
nah, probably not.
Maybe the goalies down there are a bit more careful with their posts.
So a minute 40 on the power play here for the Swarm. Stepanek up top. Finally shoots, scores! How good is this guy, Bartosz?
That killer instinct.
Look, he just, look at this. Am I gonna shoot? No. 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 Okay, I'll shoot now. That's just so good though. Little hold up. Getting the players moving and then just finding a spot and actually getting it there.
Yeah, I think Chava was a little bit deep in his crease there. You saw him, he was almost on the goal line. And you want to challenge a bit more there, especially with all that traffic in front. Because if you don't get your eyes on it, you just have to hope it hits you. So you want to get to the top of your crease and make yourself big. And I think Stepanek, being a smart goal scorer, he saw that Chubb was deep in his net there.
Oh, downtown crunch there from Ollie Hay. Good hit there. Swarm looking to try to get another one here. Power play is finished, but sometimes when Polozov's got the puck, it looks like you are on a power play. The As Dalmatale bullied there again by Flynn Hayward Jones. Up top to Simon. Smith was trying to get the block. As Ellis tried to find Smith, but just in front of his stick. And Daigle coming to clean up really well. Looks like a stickman flying onto a bench somewhere. That takes a weird carom off the boards. Admirals will finally break out. Here's Smith. Just past Andy Hayes, shoots, and a good blocker save there from Canada.
Yeah, great move by Smith, too, to create that opportunity.
Here's Johnson. Finds Mawson. Good dangle. Mawson couldn't put it home.
That was a big save by Chaba. If that was in, the game would have been over, I think.
100%. And here's PlayStation trying to find Rooney. Sula. Nice little pass up there to Sam Pillage. Mawson's given chase. Good work there from Ben Stephen. Mawson with it. He does have McDonald up high, but we'll just hold on to it, why not? Thula was crashing the back post, but a good stick in the lane there from Mason Kennedy as Chamberlain will get that out of the zone, but only as far as Sam Pillage. And Thula will give it off to Fontaine. Swarm all over them at the moment. Up by 4 goals and dominating the scoring chances.
Yeah, it's only the second period.
Mason Kennedy will give it up to Chamberlain. He'll just bat that one in. Dixon given chase. Almost stole that off McDonald. As Kozak will just sling that over to this near side. Zach Stephen had to step up there or Fontaine would have had it. Dixon with a shot hit Kozak, who was playing last man. And Taylor trying to bat that out of midair. That would have been a very impressive goal if he actually got something on that. Oh, Fontaine just couldn't get the pass up to Kozak. That would have been a breakaway for the Swarm. There's Fontaine now. He's just going to have to turn away from Taylor as he had him marked pretty well. Atwell puts that in deep. Receives a hit there from Zach Stephen.
Oh, referee's got his hand up.
He does. Looks like holding, and it's going to be on Atwell.
Oh, he's on the bench already. Come on, Atwell, get to the box.
Yeah, not exactly sure what that one was about, but
referee is just evening up the penalties, trying to give the Admirals a chance, maybe. Yeah, I missed who the hook was on.
Holly Hay will go up against Dalmatale there. Holly Hay with it, trying to leave it on for Smith. Picked off there well by Dalmatale. Here's Captain Daig. Had Hayward Jones actually crash in the back post there. Not sure he knew about it though.
This is a must score power play for the Admirals. They want to go into the third period with a chance at tying this up.
As Ellis was unable to corral that pass from Daig. So a turnover made. Simon's going to clear that all the way down and definitely waste a bit of time on this power play. Oh, look out. Communication error there between Chubba and his defenseman.
Bit of a mix-up. Luckily, didn't end up in the back of his net.
Admiral's got to get a few things going, get some shots on. Here comes Caleb Chamberlain. He'll rip a shot and straight into Canada. He needed to find the net there, but could not.
He used his acceleration well there. He can absolutely fly when he gets going, Caleb.
He's so fast.
Unfortunately, he hasn't had many chances to do that this game with how smothering the Swarm defense has been. But
And he also walks around everywhere in bare feet. He's the caveman.
I had no idea. I haven't seen him barefoot at the rink yet.
Here's Henry. Try to find McLeish on that far side, but a good stick from Johnson breaks it up momentarily. McLeish with a shot. Pad save made there from Kenne. Good rebound it was too, but there was no Admiral there to tap it home. As Johnson tries to go around Regan, he's pressured on though. Admirals get that up. Poor passing though, needed to be tape to tape, and they are going to get an icing call on it.
Yeah, that's not what you want on your power play, to get an icing against you. But they've still got 19 seconds on the power play, 27.6 seconds left in the period to make something happen.
And that's ultimately why they are down a few goals here late in this period, Bartosz. They just haven't been clinical enough. Passes haven't been going to the tape when they need to. And yeah, they're probably just not getting enough decent quality scoring chances. So,
yeah, I think they've only had two real scoring chances this period. There was Riley Smith making a nice move and getting a shot.
Yeah, Polozov's going to get a call there, I think. A little bit of hooking.
So 1 second of 5-on-3.
Yeah, 1 second.
9 seconds left in the period. If they score, they could avoid getting yelled at by their coach.
I wouldn't say that.
Maybe yelled at a little bit less.
I'd still be grilling them. They'd be coming into the changing room all with their each customized grill slip.
Maybe you won't be throwing stuff if they score, though.
This is true. Ellis with a shot. Smith's there, trying to find Flynn Hayward-Jones. Daig with a shot, could have been dangerous too. Almost got the shot, he did get the shot off, but the buzzer had gone. Looks like Canada should be fine after that last shot. Yeah, just hit him clean in the mask.
Yeah, that's not pleasant. I would not enjoy receiving a shot directly to the face from these guys.
Definitely not. So 5-1 here at the end of the second period. The Bonnie Swarm out shooting the Admirals 23-19. Like I said before, Bartosz, if they can't make tape to tape passes, break out effectively, and stop that Swarm offensive team spending so much time in their zone, you're not going to win a hockey game like that.
Yeah, and they haven't really given Chaba much chance on those shots. They were all good goals. Maybe the last goal, Chaba maybe could have played a little bit higher in his crease, but with all that traffic in front, like, I don't know if he really saw much of that shot.
Yeah, definitely two or three there, he absolutely had no chance. Even with the Stepanek one, it's hard to say. You'd have to look from behind or see a view from behind how much traffic was there, but he's a pro. He knows when to pick that exact good time to shoot. So
yeah, excellent patience from Stepanek there on the point. He waited for the perfect opportunity, picked the corner. So it's going to be tough for Chaba there.
Absolutely. But, hey, we all know the Admirals never go down with a fight. I've definitely known that from the last 20-odd years watching them. They are definitely a 60-minute team. So see if they can come back with a bit of fight and try to get a few goals. We'll take a quick break, grab a tasty beverage, and we'll be back shortly. Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen, here to Paradise Botany here in Auckland, New Zealand. I'm Bryce Rouse. Normally alongside me, he's just making his way over now, Bartosz Iwatowski. Sorry. So we've got a 5-1 game here in favour of the Botany Swarm. It's been pretty much all one-way traffic. The Admirals not really getting enough decent scoring opportunities to convert on them, but the Swarm are making them absolutely count when they do get it. Welcome back, Bartosz. How you going?
Hey, Bryce. Sorry, I'm on crutches at the moment with a fractured ankle, so the bathroom trip is a bit longer than usual.
I can confirm that. He is on crutches, so... But you're getting around all right, though. When are you back in action?
I'm hoping I'll be back for playoffs. It's been 3 weeks now with the fracture. I did it playing as a winger instead of a goalie.
There you go. That's typical of goaltenders. They all think they're the best outfield players, don't they?
Yeah, I was playing in my goalie skates, too.
Oh, you weren't.
I totally was.
Oh, dear. Well, here we go. Period three. Admirals need to get something going. What can they do? Here's Ellis. Yeah, we'll put that around for Ollie Hay. They are on the power play here for another minute and a half, so got to get some looks on net. Because mostly everything for Canada today has been, quite frankly, too easy. Shot there, that took a wicked bounce. Looked like it was destined for the back of the net, but it just missed.
Good start so far for the Admirals. Trying to get something going on this power play.
Yeah, quickly stolen there from Sandor. He's going to be able to clear that all the way down too, so more time being wasted here. The best thing about these two Auckland teams is they can travel with full squads and even get 22 players going. Two goalies, 20 skaters. Here's a shot there from Daigle. Pad save made by Canada. Henry gives it up top to Daig. He'll rip one. Took a deflection there. Batted out of midair as well. He makes another save.
Best chance of the game there, I think. Wow. Solid save by Canada. Keep his team up 5-1.
Riggs plays it up to Vespa. Good hold-up play there as Riggs comes and supports him, puts a shot on, but once again, Canada is not going to make any trouble of those. You're definitely going to shoot lower if you're just going to shoot straight. You're going to make him make a pad save so you can get some rebounds here, Bartosz.
Yeah, that's right. If there's no traffic in front, shoot low. If you've got traffic in front, you can shoot high as long as you hit the net. But, yep. Nobody blocking his eyes. He's going to make that every time.
There's McLeish. Penalty about to expire as Henry can't control that on the far side. Still has it though. Good stick in the lane from Stepanek. Knows exactly where Henry would have wanted the puck to go. Tula tries to step up and steal that off Vespa. As Chamberlain will try to utilize his speed to go around McDonald. Which he does. Riggs at the top. His shot hits someone in front. Chamberlain goes crashing into the board. Swarm will break out. Here comes Dalmatow. Tries to go through McLeish. McLeish has been pretty solid this season in terms of people trying to dangle around him. He's just playing the body. And it's working for him this season.
That's what you got to do. The opposite of what you do as a goalie. Don't play the body at all. You just play the puck.
There's a shot from Moses. Got a rebound as Reeks tried to jump on that. But the puck was still bouncing. Sam Moses was actually my roommate last weekend. I was really hoping he'd score a goal for me, but no cigar.
Yeah, I'm hoping he scores one. He was my teammate last year on the Rangers in the Beer League, Auckland Beer League. Great player, great teammate.
Yeah, he's a good guy, isn't he? As Kozak will turn around. As Simon, he shoots. Atwell tried to get a redirect on that.
That was an odd rebound there.
As Ben Stevens going to try to get something going. Goes past Simon. Can he get a centering pass? He can. Oh, pad save there just by Kennedy.
Wow, stretched out and got his toe on that.
Not sure if that would have been bouncing in, but definitely kept it in front of him. And that's just offside as Kozak was just ahead of the play.
Seeing that replay now. That odd rebound there. Yeah, I think Chava would have liked to control that a little bit better, but luckily nothing happened there.
And Chava's going to bat that away. Chamberlain will be the first there. They do clear. Hayward Jones goes up to Sebastian Stephen. Gives it up top to Flynn. Good stick in the lane there from Whitson Lee to stop Chamberlain from getting it. Chamberlain tried to harass him for the puck. And Chamberlain's going to be called here for hooking. Do you agree with that? I did not
see what he did there.
It was just on the near side here when he tried to stick lift Whitson Lee.
Oh, yeah. I didn't think there was anything in it, but oh, well. Can't argue with the referee. They won't change their mind. Caleb just dutifully goes to the box.
So maybe a tough one there on the Admirals.
Yeah, they need this penalty kill now. Can't go down by five. Oh, it's already 6-1.
Here goes Smith, though. This guy knows how to score. He does. Riley Smith, five hole on Canada.
Great goal there by Riley Smith. That was against the run of the play, out of nowhere. Looks like Kende went for the poke check, and Riley Smith didn't panic, just stayed patient and exploited that opportunity. So, looks like the Admirals are back in this game. They just need four more.
And they have had a little bit of trouble scoring goals this season, but I do think once they do start breaking out and scoring goals and finding ways to put the puck in the back of the net, they definitely are going to be a tough team come that semi-final playoff couple of games on aggregate.
Yeah, I was checking the stats recently, and Barr, who was their starting goalie before Chapa came back, actually had the highest save percentage in the league. But the Admirals were just struggling to win games because they couldn't score enough goals.
Sounds a lot like my senior non-check team.
The Wolves. The Spartans actually requested that I let you know that they destroyed the Wolves a few weeks ago. And they were very happy about this, their first win of the season.
Yeah, it was a tough one to take. Riley Smith actually almost stole the puck then off Stepanek a little bit earlier. Could have got another breakaway, but 35 seconds remaining on the power play for the Swarm, and that was almost picked off there by Smith. Here comes Kozak, unable to get a shot off though as Riggs was tracking back nicely. Loses a glove in the meantime as well. And picked up here by Smith, doing so well. Riley Smith, oh, almost got through Sandoy. If that didn't hit the skate, I think he would have got the puck through him. And looks like Sandoy's going to go to the box as well.
Oh yeah, Nguyen and Bobby Orr.
Yep, he played into Smith's hand right there.
It was a great play by Smith to steal the puck there and draw the penalty. He's putting the Admirals team on his back today, trying to claw back into this game.
Yeah, Sandoy's racking up the minutes in his last few games in the penalty box. He always seems to be in there for at least a couple of minutes, you know.
Sometimes you need a breather in the third period. He's been skating so hard, he needs a two-minute break.
That's true.
So Vespa wins that from Johnson. McLeish has got it. Here's Henry, gives it up top to Reeks. He'll rip one and a blocker save made there from Canada. Here's Caleb Chamberlain PlayStation. Shot there from Reeks. Hits traffic in front. Chamberlain gives it back to him. They come over to McLeish. Vespa trying to find the redirect on that shot. Could be a hooking call there now. It's just nicely tied up, both players. Henry comes and tidies things up. McLeish puts it low, but Vespa had to work hard to get there first. As Tula trying to go through the middle of the ice as Henry picked that off. There's McLeish. Try to find Chamberlain at the back post. He didn't control that nicely.
That was almost a tap-in.
One time there from Riggs, and that goes high. And Ryan McDonald will smash that one all the way down. Chubba has to make a save on the play.
Yeah. You got to get those shots on net from the point there when you got all that traffic in front. Even if it hits the goal, you create a rebound. Make something happen. If it hits the glass, usually the danger's over.
Here's Ollie Hay. Gives it on to Smith. He's got Regan at the back post. There's no passing lane though. Might try it now. Rebound. Smith couldn't get another shot off as Simon will clear that one all the way. Just 10 seconds remaining on the power play.
At least the Admirals got some momentum going. They had good possession, got some shots on that.
And that will be icing as Sandoy was just out on the ice, but that wouldn't have made a difference anyway. So it's just three goals that the Admirals do need. As I think they accidentally gave that extra one to the Swarm instead of the Admirals before.
Yeah, I was confused seeing 6-1 on the scoreboard.
Did they sneak one there? So down the tower against Ollie Hay. Big face off there. Probably won by Dalmatow, but Swarm didn't have a guy on the weak side. As Hay leaves it on for Smith. Tries to put a shot on, goes into the corner. Polozov's going to be there. He'll skate this one up. Still with it. Gives it to Stepanek. Goes around the back of the net. Leaves it on for Polozov. He tried to find Stepanek again, but Daigle getting a stick in the lane. Shot there from the point.
Oh, that was dangerous.
Yeah, I was waiting for it to get a redirection from a couple of players trying to hack at it, but no one ever got to it.
I think Chubba didn't see that till the last second. That's, the Swarm have done really well to get traffic in front of Chubba and take away his eyes. The Admirals, I think, need to do that to Matt Canada.
Definitely. The time is running out. And the Swarm, what they've actually been able to do as well this season is when they do get ahead in goals, they are able to finish these games and see these games out really strongly.
Yeah, we haven't seen any third period meltdowns from them this season. They are a winning team. They know how to win.
Definitely saw a couple in most recent years. As Mason Kennedy will shoot one, but no source on that. Picked off there by Ben Steven, but the puck will come out to center ice.
As a Leafs fan, I wish they would learn something from the Swarm and avoid those third period playoff meltdowns that have crushed my hopes for 17, 18, however many years.
Dixon gives it up to the point. Kennedy with a shot, hits Sandoy in front. Nice backhand pass here from Fontaine to Kozak. Kozak trying to find Atwell. Couldn't get a shot off.
Oh, great play, almost a tap in there.
There's Ben Steven trying to make a few moves. He gets bullied there by Sandoy. And he goes in for a hit himself on Fontaine. As Taylor will go it to the far side. Sebastian Stephen trying to dump it in, but it looks like it hit the referee. Look out.
Yeah, you don't want to be hitting the zebras. They won't appreciate that.
Battle in the neutral zone as Johnson takes it into the offensive area. Looks like Zach Stephen doing a good job in defense, but the Swarm will still have it in the zone. Left on for Whitson Lee. Might have been tripped there. No, he wasn't. Shot there from the point. A rebound attempt. Cleared away by Nash Hayward-Jones. Looks like this fourth line's getting a bit of time out there tonight for the Admirals, and they actually haven't done too bad considering.
Yeah, might as well give them a chance when they're down so much. See if they can get something going. The shots are actually even at the moment, 28 to 28. Although I think the shot count doesn't tell the full story. The Swarm shots have been much higher quality chances for the most part. And Matt Kennedy, he's made a few good saves, but he hasn't been tested quite as much as Chaba this game. A lot of the shots are easy ones that he can see, take into his chest and cover up.
Swarm have definitely been the better side here tonight. I do know for sure the Admirals probably just didn't get out of third or fourth gear, to be honest. Yeah, I think they might just be quite content with that third place. They definitely will make a two-game playoff. Based on aggregate at the end of those. Good hit there by Mawson. Looks like that was on Daig. Daig wasn't too happy about it, but he does have the puck on his stick now anyway. Gives it over to Smith. Smith shoots, and a big glove save there from Kennedy.
He loves to make those stylish glove saves.
He wakes up on a day of hockey, and he's like, all right, let's get the Kennedy show started.
Every day is Canada Day, Canada Day. Absolutely hot dogging out there with those glove saves.
There goes Ryan McDonald, one of the imports here for the Swarm this season. Try to go through Flynn. Here's a shot there from Stepanek. Scores!
What a shot. Absolute snipe. Top shelf. No chance for Chaba there. It was just a defensive breakdown. And Chaba managed to get to the top of the crease, but Stepanek just picked his spot. Shelfed it.
He's got a... I don't think anyone can deny that he's the best player in the league. It's either him or Brendan Walker, but...
I think it's Stepanek.
And I've seen all the highlights from Walkham's games, but I love his style, but Stepanek is the man, the myth, the legend at the moment here in this league.
He is such a complete player. He is smart. He's got the size. He's got the shot. There's no denying that, in my opinion, he is the best player in the league.
As Fontaine's going to have it with his speed. Leaves it on for Atwell, who whiffed on it. There's Sandoy. Fontaine with a redirect.
Wow, what a save by Chaba there. Good read.
And to stay in the game too, quite late. I'd probably lose my head now if I was a goalie down 6-2.
Yeah, as a goalie, you stay hungry till the end. You don't want to mess up your save percentage goals against average.
That's true.
All about those stats. Battle till the end. And Chaba has battled well. He's given his team a chance. But unfortunately, he's dealt with some pretty difficult shots. A lot of them unstoppable, really. Those deflections, not much you can do there.
And then Stepanek, not much you can do there either.
Yeah, especially on that defensive breakdown where it just pops to him and you're not really expecting him to get the puck.
Simon will just give that over to Sandoy. Lovely little lift. Ben Stephen tracking back. So the coach of the Admirals actually has his three sons playing for the team as well. So I got to spend a lot of time with Cam Stephen last weekend. Brilliant guy. Funny, yeah. Funny, composed, just a real hockey guy, you know.
Yeah, he's a good guy. I play with him on Sunday mornings at Darren Blong's scrim. So he has a lot of former Ice Blacks and other players come out to his scrim, and Cam comes along as well. Sometimes he brings his boys too for a bit of family hockey fun.
Here goes Morrison. He's going to try to go to the net. Puts a shot on, and big save there from Chubba. Well needed.
Yeah, well done, Chubba. Didn't panic. Held his ground.
Keep going along the story there. But,
oh, yeah, Darren scrims. Yeah, Darren Blong, former Ice Black. I think he played for the Swarm, is that right?
Nah, he was Admiral.
He was an Admiral. Oops, yeah. Sorry, Darren. So he was an Admiral, and he still got it. He scores those between-the-legs goals on me.
Really?
You know, his daughter, Katia Blong, so she scored 8 goals against Estonia at the Under-18 Women's Tournament this year. And she loved those between-the-legs goals as well. She came in on me on a breakaway, and I was not expecting it. Between-the-legs top corner shelved it on me, embarrassed me.
And I know, for one, it is quite hard to score on you, Bartosz.
Oh, thank you.
Only when you haven't had some pre-game bevvies.
Yeah, pre-game wine, that's the trick. To get loosened up, would not recommend as a player, but as a goalie, it can help you get in the game and calm those nerves.
I can see how that would work. The Admiral's trying to clear as Thula's going to dance and pass the puck up to Polozov. Down low for Stepanek. Try to find Polozov, who was still crashing the net, and lucky Chubba was up to the task there, as that could have been 7.
Another good positional play. His post play has been very good today. We've seen a number of goals scored this season from goalies maybe being a little bit lax on their post play and not paying attention on those short side jam plays. But Chubba's done very well today. Kept all of those under control.
Shot there from Kozak, but looks like it hit someone in front, so it went wide as Hayward Jones is going to break out. Gives it over to Ollie Hay. Nice little move there, but Luke Simon did stay with the play. Good to see Hay and Atwell going at it. I know deep down they're friends, but out on the ice, absolute enemies. Fontaine just gets out of the zone, receives a good hit from Ollie Hay as well.
It's interesting, a lot of these guys get mixed up together in the BHL in our summer league and end up playing together. And then when the winter season starts, they're rivals again.
Here's Fontaine, gives it up to Jonsson. Jonsson scores!
Was that Fontaine?
No, that was Jonsson. Fontaine made the pass, but Jonsson got the last shot up. We'll see here. So Jonsson shoots, and it looks like it just trickles over eventually.
Ouch. That's tough as a goalie. I hate those goals. They annoy the crap out of me. You make the save, and you think you've got it. It just trickles in. That's a tough one for Chubba. He should hold his head high. He's made a lot of good saves this game, and most of the goals haven't really been his fault. Not much he could have done on most of them.
Stuller finds Whitson Lee. McLeish has to tidy up. Henry just knocks that out of danger. And Thula receives a hit there from Vesper. Vesper with it. Gives it up to Sestrone. Sestrone with a shot. Looks like a hit. Hit a defenseman. Shot there for the point. Swarm all clear. As Mawson and Regan have a big collision down there. Love to see that. As Riggs tries to go around, that's holding. That's definitely got to be a penalty.
That is the most clear penalty of the game today. He just wrapped his arms around him.
Like they're about to do the, what's that dance? I don't know, some howdy partner kind of thing.
Yeah, Yeah, he was definitely looking for a
Joe, maybe. That's definitely a song that should have played for that move that Sandor did there on Riggs.
His second trip to the box today.
Yeah, I don't mind him taking that one. That's okay, but when the game's like kind of still on the edge, it's I don't like those ones.
Yeah. At this point, the Admirals, I think, are just trying to get some momentum going into tomorrow's game. 7-2 is not a scoreline you're happy with, but if they can get a goal or two and carry that momentum into tomorrow, I think that's the best they can hope for at this moment.
As Fraser got nailed there on the near side by McDonald. Looks like the Admirals are making sure they finish all their hits, but it looks like the Swarm are saying, hey, if you guys are going to do that, we will do the same as well.
Yeah, I think Swarm have the edge in size with Stepanek and Mawson being two really big bodies.
Yeah, Smith just slows things down. Henry fresh out on the ice. Daigle one time. Oh, that was a rocket. Looks like, not sure who that hit, but Fontaine gets a little stick there too. Henry has to come clean up. And Fontaine's getting back there with no stick. So it's pretty much 5-on-3. Wow, Fontaine, look at him go.
Using his soccer skills.
The kid can do it all. Someone get that guy a job or something up here once he's finished studying, because we don't want him to go back to Christchurch. We want to keep him here in Auckland. He can come stay at my house if he wants. As Whitson Lee's going to try to go to the net. On the backhand, Whitson Lee! And it would not go. Puck still loose. Oh, early whistle should not have been whistled. Puck was not covered, but...
Referee a bit too keen with the whistle there, but good saves by Chuba. Good play by Josh Winston Lee. That persistence.
At no time was the puck covered up either.
No, it was not. The puck is definitely much easier to see than the blue and the red lines today, so... Bit of a boo-boo from the referee there. But oh well, Admirals are happy. They got the whistle. And just waiting on some line changes here. Got Atwell out there for the face-off.
Yeah, McLeish will be there. Gives it over to the left side for Dixon. Received a hit there too from Atwell. Here goes Simon. He'll grip one. Man, that guy can absolutely shoot. It doesn't look like he would be one of the harder shooters out there, but he can really rip.
Yeah, he's scored quite a few goals this season, actually. He scored a nice one against Queenstown. I believe it was on a 2-on-1. And shelved it short side.
Look at this. Sandor is going to be going straight for the box. It's going to be an interference call because I believe he only had one skate on the ice before he tried to impede the player. So.
Naughty boy Sandor. Was it him in the box before there?
Yeah, so he was coming out of the box. I'm pretty sure he didn't have 2 feet planted on the ice before he threw his stick out, tried to get the puck or something. We'll have to see a replay, but that's got to be the fastest. So you'll see a penalty for 2 minutes, and then literally 121 seconds after that, you'll see him get his next one, I think.
Oh, that's hilarious.
Probably won't be exactly 1 second. It's probably around about 3 or 4, depending when the clock stop. But hey, we've seen it all today then. Shot there from... Oh, Canada doing so well. Big shot there from Ellis from the point.
Yeah, good catch there. No rebound. Stops the play. Canada is looking pretty tough to beat today.
I think Remy might have done it by purpose. Like, they've won the game. Let's just get some special teams out there. Smith shoots. Looks like a hit someone or something in front. He'll get the puck back though. He's got Daigle over there. He'll rip one. Looks like a stick save there from Kennedy. McDonald receives a good hit from Ollie Hay.
Maybe Remy was enjoying a beer in the box there and wanted a few more minutes to finish his beer. He's right by the concession stand there. Maybe having some chips too. It's okay. The Swarm don't need him at the moment. They're definitely in control.
I think Ryan McDonald's having a yarn there with Ollie Hay, maybe saying, man, I love the way how you just keep dishing hits out. As that's wrapped right round. So Smith actually plays in the defensive role when they are on the power play, from what I've seen, alongside Daigle, and then they normally get... So they normally do have two defensemen out there, but he will start on the face-off as a D.
Yeah, I believe naturally he is a defenseman, although he has been used as a forward for most of the season by the Admirals. But as you saw for the Swarm, they used to panic on the point as well. That's fairly common now to use a forward on the point on the power play.
Oh, Polozov trying to steal that off Smith. Polozov, he's got hooked though from Smith. So Smith draws the hooking call. As the two foreigners go absolutely at it, as they probably had to be made.
That was a bit of a mistake there by Smith. So I think the score isn't going to change much with 1 minute left and 4-on-4 action.
Probably not. It's good to see Polozov working really hard this season. You can tell that he's really enjoying that team vibe, and I can see it in his game. Like the last two, three seasons, I haven't seen this Polozov for a little while, and that's a happy Polozov.
He is an incredible playmaker, and I think he's thriving with so many good shooters around him. He can feed them the puck, and they put it in the net.
1 minute remaining in the third period.
So icing waved off here.
I don't think Kende needed to touch that.
I think the refs probably just want to keep it going. There's Nash Hayward-Jones, unable to corral that. Just down the towel, shoots, and a good glove save by Chubba.
Very nice glove save.
Probably should have pulled Chubba with maybe 4 or 5 minutes to go, you know, get Jaden Burt a little bit of ice time, as he didn't see any last weekend as he traveled, but this is the big league, this is the show, and I know game time will be quite hard to come by, so.
Yeah, the Admirals are definitely riding Chubba for the last bit of this season to try and secure the playoff spot. And with Barr and Gavin going away soon to university, I believe Barr is going to the U.S. to play ACHA hockey, and Gavin is going to Queen's University in Canada. The rival of my former university, University of Western Ontario, which regularly beat Queen's University in hockey and football.
And that's gonna do it here for game one of the weekend. The Botany Swarm take a 7-2 win over their crosstown rivals, the West Auckland Admirals. Total shots, 35-32 in favor of the Botany Swarm. A pretty all-round good performance here by the Swarm. Not too many things they did wrong, but they did a lot of things right. And as a coach, you're probably telling your team, what more do you want from them after that, right?
Yeah, that was a solid game from the Swarm. They were absolutely the dominant team. And I think the shot count doesn't actually reflect their dominance. 35-32, but most of those, well, a lot of those 35 shots were very high quality scoring chances. They gave Chubba a lot to deal with. Whereas the Admirals, a lot of their shots were without much traffic in front and made it a bit easy for Kende, although he managed to make a few flashy glove saves. He took his opportunity to windmill it whenever he could, trying to add to his highlight reel.
That's true. He loves a bit of flashy leather every now and then, and why not when he gets given the chance? So let him go for it, I reckon. But so now, Bartosz, the Admirals, what went wrong today?
Well, I think they struggled in front of the net to deal with. As you saw, we had a few deflections. The first goal was a one-timer in front of the net.
Yeah.
They weren't tying up the Swarm players in front of the net, getting their sticks on their sticks, preventing them from getting those tips, those one-timers. And I think they just generally struggled to break out of their zone. We didn't see too many odd man rushes for the Admirals. We had a lot of shots that were just one man skating across the blue line, putting into Kende's chest. So it's going to be tough. The Swarm are a complete team. It's going to be difficult. They're going to need Chaba to play a great game again. And I think they're going to need a bit of luck tomorrow as well.
Like, I think the effort's always there from them, but you know, when you can't spend time in the opposition's zone, you're never going to win hockey games. And we saw the Swarm do that. They could just sustain the pressure, get goal-scoring opportunities, and defend well. So ultimately, that's what got them over the line here today. But it's been a good game one. It's been absolutely packed house in here. If you're not doing anything and you are in the Auckland area, get on down here to Paradise Botany for, let's just say, a 4:45 p.m. puck drop. Be here nice and early, grab some tasty beverages. I've been your host, Bryce Rouse, alongside Bartosz Ewertowski.
Oh, that's right. I like how you roll the R's.
That's a good one, wasn't it?
Very Polish of you. They're nice.
Thank you, everybody, and we will see you here, same time, same place tomorrow evening for Game 2.
See you, guys.
Thank you, everyone, and good night.